In this video, we show how you can use objects as a type and also how to use inheritance. So these are important concepts in object-oriented programming. So in this video, we concentrate on the coding and we go through quite a lot of material. So we start off looking at objects as a type. So we can use ints, integers, and lists and dictionaries as attributes inside a class. Well, why not an object? Well, we can. So for our student class, we're going to create a student using the name object of first name and surname. So we'll show you how to do that in code, how to create the student and print the details, for example. Now, inheritance. When you have classes that have attributes and methods that are similar, you don't want to keep reusing the code. So you have a superclass that has methods and attributes, and then has subclasses that can use those same attributes and methods. So they can inherit the details of the superclass, like the attributes and methods. They can also overwrite that. So it might sound quite complicated, but if you watch this video to the end, you'll learn a lot about how you can use these superclasses, subclasses, how to use inheritance, how to use objects as types inside the classes. So watch closely, there's a lot of material taken in here. And if you're not sure, fine, you might need to watch it more than once, but that's fine. But we're going to show you how to do this in the code. So this video will be very much code based. Here we have a simplified version of our class student with just a number and a name. We can print them using the printDetails method. Now we want to add their full name, first name and surname. So we could do that with attributes, and just instead of having name, we could have first name and surname. But what we want to do here, we want to introduce a new class called name and then use that with first name and surname. So we're going to use the new class called name inside the student class. Now there's nothing really new with our new class we're going to call name, so we've prepared it and we're just going to paste the code in. So you can see here we've got class name, we've got self as usual, and first name and surname. So we need to pass these in when we define the name. So now when we create the student objects, we're going to create the name object as well. So here we've got the two students, their numbers, and instead of just creating one name, we create the object name with their first name and surname. Now you can see when we run this, if we use the print details as it is at the moment, we're just going to print the number, and then the name is just going to print at the location of the object. So how might we access these details? Well, we've got the class name, the object name inside the student. Well, we can use the object, which is name, dot first name, dot surname. So now when we print these, you can see we've got the first name and the surname of the two students. So we use the student object, st1, then dot name, then dot first name, the attribute. Now we've got a method called print details, so we need to change that. So instead of just printing self.name, what we need to do is we're going to print the self.name.firstname, self.name.surname. So we're calling the attributes from the name function. So we don't need the initial print statements. Now we've got our print details, we can run this. You can see we've got our number, our first name, and our surname. So we've used the class name and name objects inside a class student. Now we want to change our code, and we want to have a class person, and we want to be able to use the attributes and methods from the class person for students and teachers. So the first thing we need to do with our code, we need to change the superclass, the main class, to person. So now we have class person, and we need to create a class student, and we're just going to use the word pass and class teacher, and pass. And what we need to do, we need to put in brackets that these are subclasses from superclass person. So we have the class student and the class teacher, and they are subclasses, like children, if you like, of the parent class person. So now everything from person will go into student, and everything from person will go into teacher. So student and teacher, both those classes, when we create those objects, we'll get everything that's in person. So that's quite straightforward, but now we have to think, the class name is fine, we don't need to change that, but we need to think how we're going to change creating a student and creating a teacher with the class person and the print details. So let's think what we need to do first. So let's look at our code. We've got the number and the name, which we've got from the class name, for a person. And these are going to be the same for student and teacher. Well, we already created two students. So what happens if we run the code? Well, we run the code and we've got the two student details. So we don't need to change that. So we could include, let's say, a teacher equals teacher, and let's give the teacher a number and a name. What should we call? Let's just say Dr. and Codie. And if we want to print the details of the teacher, you can say teacher 1 dot print details. So let's try this. There we go. So we can just put in a print, let's say print teacher and print students. Right, let's try this again. So we've got students, we've got two students, and then we have our teacher. So we've created a student and a teacher class, and we've used the same code for both because both of them have a number and a name. We've used print details, and we've also used the name class in the person. So that sounds quite complicated, but all we've done is we've just changed the student class to a person class, and then just made the student and the teacher use the attributes and the methods inside that class. So we can see here, we've got class student, class teacher, and they inherit all of the attributes and methods from class person. So when we create the student object or the teacher object, we can create the same as if we had the methods and attributes actually inside that class already. So you can see this inheritance has already saved us time creating a new object of teacher. Well, we could have really just copied and pasted the code, So there must be some more advantages. Well, the student and the teacher are different. So let's imagine that we want our class teacher to be different than the student, and also slightly different from person. So let's imagine we add something from the teacher where we add, let's say, a department. So now we can use the attributes and methods from person, but we're not limited to them. So we can actually change the class teacher so it gains the benefits of the person class, but it can also add other things in there. It can be different. So we've already written code here, but here we override the initial function, and here we've added the department. So we've got the, first of all, we've got the initial function that we've got from the superclass. So we use super brackets dot initial number and name. So that gives us the initial class from the person, and then we add the department. So now when we get the student, when we create the teacher, we need to add a department, let's say computer science. So also when we print the details from the teacher, we can add, so here we've got the number, the department, first name and surname. You can see we've put self.name.firstname, self.name.surname. So let's give an overview of that. We've got class person. Class student at the moment just does exactly the same as person. It inherits the attributes and methods from person. Class teacher also inherits everything, but we've slightly changed things. We've overridden them. So we've got the superclass initial method, and we've added department. And we've also added that department when we print details. So the student print details will be the same as the person, but the print details in teacher is different. It overrides the parent method. So if you don't define the new print details, it will use the parent print details. But if you do, it will override it. So now we've got the student, we've got the print student details, we've got the teacher, and now we've got the teacher with the department and print details. So let's try that. Let's just put a print statement in here to separate them. And let's run this. So we've got the two students like before, and we've got the teacher with the number, department, first name and surname. So you can see parent class, child class that just inherits everything, and here we've overridden the methods for initializing the object and printing the details. We've also used the class name to create the name as we did before, have student and teacher. So we've done quite a lot there. We've covered quite a lot quickly, but that's basically what happens when we use inheritance. The superclass we can define, we put that in the brackets, the child class gets the same attributes methods, but also can change them. So that's our final code. Well, we've covered a lot there, haven't we? So if you've watched all that and you understand it, that's great. Please give us a like if you liked it. If you haven't already, please subscribe. And if you want to keep up with this series and get notified when we're going to release the videos, click that notification bell.